Robotic surgery is just an expansion of laparoscopy. So the robot allows to provide better visualization and better articulation, but essentially it's laparoscopic surgery amplified.
There are two cameras, as you can see, and those two cameras allows for that parallax view to give you that three-dimensional imaging. And so that's one of the things that separates this from straight laparoscopy.
There are two parts to the robot. There's a part that's connected to the patient at the bedside, and then there's a separate console that the surgeon works from. All the instruments that are moving on the inside of the patient are being controlled by the surgeon. So the monitor demonstrates a paperclip, so it gives you a size, and it shows that with suturing, we can both sew with the right hand or with the left hand, and it essentially makes most surgeons ambidextrous. The robot still has the ability to see and work through a smaller hole and do more. So single site surgery is one advantage. And there's certain areas of the body that the surgeon works in that has the advantage of seeing better and working more fine detail with the robot. So currently, I use the robot for single site gallbladder surgery. Most patients enjoy that because they wind up with 1-2 centimeter or 1-inch incision at the belly button, and most of the patients come back and you can't even tell they have a scar. And although it's still early, I think we'll see that the outcomes will be better for robotic assisted laparoscopic hernia repair compared to straight laparoscopic. And so traditionally the laparoscopic approach primarily patched hernias. The robotic approach allows us to actually close the defect in addition to patching it. The risk of any surgery are pretty standard, and I emphasize that robotic surgery is just laparoscopic surgery to another level, and so the risks aren't any more than with laparoscopic surgery or with general surgery. So it is surgery, and a lot of the skills that we have acquired and trained to practice surgery, we apply to this. There are certain skill sets that are, in addition to that, that require additional training. There's a stepwise process that generally is in place to provide the surgeon with the baseline training, hands-on training, and then finally each individual facility has their own credentialing process before the surgeon can practice this way.